The Principality of Monaco. Next day on our trip, we arrived by train. We were so surprised to see the underground tunnels that lead you out to the surface, paved with marble tiles. We continued to explore the streets of Monaco, with its high fashion boutiques and splendid luxury apartments. A detour via Place du Casino is a must in order to admire the masterpiece by Charles Garnier. This place will take your breath away. The casino's gaming rooms are marvelously decorated with stained glass, windows, and sculptures. Every season, the most beautiful opera shows are staged here. At the end, spend some time exploring the casino's gardens and terraces with their beautiful flower beds and diverse species of plants. We continued our tour towards the market, La Codamine, which is an experience of the traditional Monaco. Then we had a long stroll through the streets to explore the real pulse of life. It is a quick 30-minute train ride away from Nice, but it has the feel of another world. A place of sublime natural beauty, Monaco has the lush vegetation and balmy weather of the Côte d'Azur. Strolling around, we found lots of seductive scenery, like deep blue sea, graceful palm trees, and vibrant parks with flowers. The most dramatic feature is a steep, a rocky promontory sticking out into the Mediterranean, called Le Rocher, which contains the historic site of Monaco. I made a separate video from this place called Monaco Town. At the foot of the cliff, Monaco's harbor is a busy port scene, packed with yachts. It is a nice place for a stroll, where the sailboats bob up and down on the waves opposite office blocks, resembling a New York business district.